Good morning, friends. In last lecture, we have explained about the preparation of the feed bed and the procurement of the quality seeds. So, the procurement of the quality seed means obtaining good or best quality cocoons of the desired strain or the varieties of the silk moth in a greenages or in the centers of the government certified seed producers, obtaining male and females or adult male and females, so as to manage the breeding activities to obtain the egg card seeds or to obtain the eggs, so as to provide them to the sericulturist or the farmers. So these are the activities performed in the greenages or the government certified seed producers, which are involved in the production of large quantity of eggs, fertilized eggs in the form of egg card seeds from the selected varieties of the silk moth, that is, which are then obtained from the cocoons, selected variety, good quality cocoons, disease free laying seeds that are obtained from the disease free laying seeds. Means these are cocoons or the adult male and females which are disease free or grown properly and used for the preparation of the egg card seeds. So this is what the activity is called as procurement of the quality seeds, obtaining the fertilized eggs in the form of egg card seeds to get the silkworm larvae of the Bombyx mori, so as to rear them further in the rearing house. Then we also have explained about the various methods of the procurement of quality seeds, that is preparation of the egg card seeds, followed by or after hatching of about 10 to 11 days, the larvae are brushed or transferred from the egg card seed to the feed bed or the rearing trays. Then what kind of mulberry leaves or the feed should be fed to the young larvae or older larvae. So all these things we have explained last time. So today we will explain about the different methods of the silkworm rearing in the rearing house. There are three methods of the silkworm rearing, that is self rearing method, plure rearing method and shoot rearing method. So first we will explain about self rearing method. So in this method, the self or the rack, which are prepared by using the wooden rods or the bamboo, can be kept in the rearing house. So last time we have explained about the rearing stand, dimensions of the rearing stand, which are made up of wooden rods and having height of up to 8 feet and having 10 self, having 10 self with each with a 20 centimeter space, and where we can keep the feed beds or the rearing trays for the feeding of silkworm larvae in the rearing house. So in each of the room of the rearing house, we can keep 6 rearing stands, and each of the rearing stand can accommodate 10 to 11 feeding trays or the feed beds or the rearing trays, and this method is called as self rearing method. So in a self rearing, we used to the bamboo rearing trays, which are prepared from the bamboo or bamboo mats, which are usually prepared by using the bamboo mats, so as to prepare either circular or rectangular rearing trays. So rearing of the silkworms in a round bamboo trays or rectangular bamboo trays, which are arranged one over other in a tiers or in a several layers, which are stacked on one on another, is called as self rearing. So we'll keep these rearing trays, about 10 to 11 rearing trays, can be kept in a single rearing stand. Then larvae are fed on the chopped mulberry leaves. So while already we have explained about the feed bed, preparation of the feed bed or rearing trays. So the rearing trays, either circular or round or the rectangular, we prepare the feed bed. That is, first we'll spread the newspaper or a thick card sheet in a floor of the rearing tray. Then we spread the chopped mulberry leaves with a good quality, and so as to maintain the humidity in the rearing bed, feed bed, we used to the water soaked foam rubber strips in the four corners of the or four sides of the rearing tray, and on which we again put another paper or the paraffin paper, so as to avoid the water loss or the so as to maintain humidity in the feed bed. In such way we prepare the feed bed. So such 10 to 11 feed beds or the rearing trays can be kept in a single rearing stand, and there are about six rearing stands. Such a six rearing stands can be kept in the rearing room, and chopped mulberry leaves are fed to the silkworm larvae, and there is a economy of the space. In this method, there is a economy of the space, means within a little space also we can accommodate or we can grow or feed or rear large number of larvae in a tiers, in a 10 to 11 tiers or in a 10 to 11 layers, that is stacking of feed beds or the rearing trays on a rearing stand, and thus ultimately there is a saving of the space. But this requires more labor or the manpower for handling trays, for handling of the rearing trays, or for the provision or feeding of the silkworm larvae, or cleaning of the feed beds or the rearing trays requires more manpower. So it is having the advantage that this requires little space, but requires more labor for the feeding of the silkworm larvae or handling the rearing trays. So this is the image photograph showing self-rearing and the two person who are involved in the feeding of mulberry leaves to the growing larvae in the round feeding trays, which are we can see that these are prepared by using the bamboo mat, and on the side there is a small side wall with a height of up to 5 to 6 centimeter, and these two person who are involved in the feeding of the mulberry leaves by removing the feeding tray or trays from the rack or rearing stand, and which has been kept onto the feeding stand, and spreading or sprinkling the mulberry leaves for the feeding of the larvae. So this is the self-rearing methods, and there are several, we can see there are three rearing stands, each with number of rearing trays, that is about 10 rearing trays are kept in a single rearing stand, and there are such three rearing stands which are kept on the side of the on the all sides of the rearing room, and the person involved in the feeding of the mulberry leaves to the silkworm larvae. So this is self-rearing method of the silkworms in a mulberry sericulture. This is another image where the rearing trays are prepared rectangular or a square, in a square shape, that are also kept in the stand, which is prepared by using the wooden rods. By using wooden rods, the rearing stands are prepared, and there are several rearing trays with a rectangular size kept one over other in the self. So this is also self rearing, and showing the rearing stands and the rearing tray, and the which are kept in the self, and can also see the larvae which are growing or feeding in the rearing trays. Then this is another image where also we can see these are the this is the rectangular rearing tray, and the white colored about the fourth instar, third or fourth instar silkworm larvae of the Bombyx mori, which are feeding onto the mulberry leaves and lilies, who are involved in the spreading of mulberry leaves or providing mulberry leaves for the feeding of the silkworm larvae of the fourth instar stages, or these are the much later stages of the development of the silkworms, and these are about fourth or fifth instar stages. So this is also the image showing the rearing stand in a left side, and the ladies who are involved in the spreading or sprinkling, providing the mulberry leaves to the silkworm larvae in a rearing tray which has been rectangular in size. Then second method, so self-rearing method, where the number of self or the rearing stands are used in the rearing house for the silkworm rearing or feeding of the silkworm rearing. Then second method is plural rearing method. In this method, rearing of the silkworm is done on fixed rearing seats or the benches with a size of 5 to 7 by 1 to 1.5 meter size, and these are constructed in a 2 or 3 tiers of wooden or bamboo strips, and leaves are fed in a choped state. So choped mulberry leaves can be fed to the larvae on the floor benches. So this is a floor rearing, and this type of silkworm rearing can also be done in the rearing house. So in the rearing house, there are two methods of the silkworm rearing. One is self rearing method and second is floor rearing method. So in self rearing method, already we have seen the images where the series of rearing stands can be kept in the rearing house or in the rearing room, accommodating 10 to 11 rearing trays, maybe circular or rectangular, and choked mulberry leaves can be fed, or even the entire leaves, only leaves, entire leaves without chopping can also be fed to the silkworm larvae in the self rearing. Similarly, the in a plural rearing, the floor benches with a size of 5 to 7 meter length and 1 to 1.5 meter width. So this size of the floor benches in a 2 or 3 tiers can be prepared onto the stands. These are also stands which are prepared by using the wooden material or the bamboo strips, and a series of floors, that is in a tiers, are prepared on the rearing stands with a length of 5 to 7 meter length. So about 7 meter length and 1 to 1.5 meter width floor bed or seats or the benches prepared in 2 or 3 or more number of tiers. That will again depend upon the height of the rearing house. If the rearing house is much larger and having the height up to 25 or more than this, 25 feet or more than this, then we can prepare the floor benches or the seats maybe 2, 3, 4 or 5. So large number of floor benches or the seats prepared in the rearing house on sides or in the even the center, by keeping a distance, a particular distance of about 1 or 2 meters for the management or for the workers, so as to take care or handle the different activities of the silkworm rearing in the rearing house. So there should be a space for the different working for the workers or laborers to feed the silkworm larvae. So we can prepare several floor benches or the seats on a stand. That is also a stand prepared on either sides or even in the center if there is much width of the room is if much more, then several floor stands can also be prepared, and each with several floor seats or the benches, 2, 3, 4, 5, so that will depend upon the height of the rearing house. So in this method, rearing of the silkworm is done on fixed rearing seats or benches with a length of 5 to 7 meter and a width of 1 to 1.5 meter. So these are constructed once in the rearing house in a 2 or 3 or more number of tires, and leaves are fed in a choped state, or even leaves can be fed directly without chopping, or even in certain cases we can see in the photographs, the entire shoots or the branches can also be kept transversely on the floor benches for the feeding of the silkworm larvae. So this is much economical than first method. In a self rearing, we require more number of labors, but in this method it does not require much labor, or labor manpower required is less in a handling trays, because there are no rearing trays. Simply the workers or labor has to manage the provision of the mulberry leaves or feed to the silkworm larvae, or cleaning and bed changing type of activities that are that will require less labor than the first rearing method, that is self rearing method. So it is economical than self rearing method, and it does not require more labor for handling trays, and this method is used in Japan. Then third method, that is a shoot rearing method. It is also similar to the floor rearing method. This method is also very similar to floor rearing method. Silkworms are reared on big benches in a 1 or 2 tires. The big shoots are harvested from the field and are fed directly to the worms. Means there is a difference in a floor rearing method and shoot rearing method. In a floor rearing method, the similar size benches, but the dimension or the length of floor benches or sheets is less, that is up to 7 meter length, and 2 to 3 tires or seats or benches are prepared on a single stand. In a shelf or in a stand, 2 or 3 tired or 2 or 3 seats or benches are prepared, and silkworm larvae are fed by choped mulberry leaves or entire whole mulberry leaves with chopping or without chopping. So mulberry leaves are fed either in a choped condition or without chopping can also the leaves are fed to the silkworm larvae in the floor rearing method. In a shoot rearing method, the benches prepared are having much longer length. The length of the floor benches or sheets is very long. That will again depend upon the length of the rearing house. So long, any length floor benches, any length floor benches can be prepared in a several tires, maybe up to 5 tires with a larger rearing house. When the rearing house is much larger, having much of the height, and in that case the rearing stands to prepare the floor benches are much larger in size and may have 2 to 3 or up to 4 or 5 benches or seats can also be prepared, or floor benches can be prepared in the rearing house, and the silkworm larvae are fed directly onto the cuttings or the branches of the mulberry which has been harvested by using branch cutting or shoot harvest method. So entire shoot or the branches are brought into the rearing house, and that are kept transversely onto the long floor branches, and where the silkworm feeding or rearing is done on a big sized floor branches. So this is called as a shoot rearing. So instead of using simple or individual mulberry leaves, only mulberry leaves, entire branches are fed to the silkworm larvae, and thus is called as a shoot rearing. This shoot rearing can also be done directly onto the ground, just the half feet or about 20 centimeter height. The large sized floor or a mat or a plastic sheet can be spread over the earth surface directly, and outdoor shoot rearing can also be practiced, but this requires favorable conditions of the temperature. There should be a shade. There should not be direct exposure of sunlight to the feeding larvae or growing larvae directly onto the ground. That is outdoor shoot rearing. That is called as outdoor shoot rearing. That can also be practiced in certain regions. So in shoot rearing, the method is very similar to floor rearing, but only in a difference is, in a floor rearing, the number of seats or floor benches prepared are up to 2 or 3 tiers, and with a size or length of the floor benches is very much less. That is only up to 7 meter, 5 to 7 meter length floor benches with a width of 1 to 1.5 meter width are prepared in a 2 or 3 tiers only, and mulberry leaves, choked mulberry leaves or unchoked mulberry leaves are fed to the silkworm larvae. And in a shoot rearing method, this method is very similar to floor rearing. Silkworms are reared on a big benches in 1 or 2 or more tiers, and the big shoots or the entire mulberry branches harvested from the field are fed directly to the silkworms. And the rearing seeds are usually 1 meter wide and of any length long. The rearing seeds are usually 1 meter wide and any length long. So this is about the shoot rearing. So shoot rearing can usually done on a single tier 20 centimeter above the ground. Shoot rearing can also be practiced in a single tier on a ground 20 centimeter above on the land or ground, and this is called as outdoor shoot rearing. Outdoor shoot rearing when the atmospheric conditions are favorable. When the atmospheric conditions are favorable. So to change the bed, and in this case, in case of shoot rearing or outdoor shoot rearing, to change the bed, ropes parallel to each other are stretched on the old bed, and new branches are placed or kept on these ropes. When all the larvae climb up onto the branches for the feeding purpose, the ropes are rolled into loose bundles, and that are transferred to other bed or new site or new place, and the old bed or litter means the waste or the remains of the free branches, empty branches which has been fed, leaves has been fed by the silkworms, and only branches or the cuttings and its waste material, that is litter, that can be cleaned, that can be removed from the old bed, and the ropes and branches are spread again, thus making new bed. So for changing the feed bed, or that is called as bed changing or cleaning, so the parallel ropes can be used. The ropes which are kept parallel or stretched parallel, and the fresh mulberry branches are kept onto the ropes, so that what happens, the larvae which are present on the seat or plastic seat or mat that will climb up the freshly harvested mulberry branches for the feeding purpose, and there is just a rolling of the ropes loosely, so that will form a loose bundle of the branches together with the larvae feeding onto the mulberry leaves or the branches that are simply kept on one side, and entire bed which has spoiled by the feces or the waste material or empty branches that are removed, or entire ground or the floor. Even this method can also be adopted in the floor rearing also. So the two ropes on two sides can be stretched throughout the length of the floor bed even in the rearing house, and fresh mulberry branches are kept onto the ropes, and that is then rolled into a bundle, and that will go to one end of the floor bench. So the entire floor bench or the floor bed will be cleaned up, removing branches and the feces. So whatever the bed which has spoiled or became dirty, that will be cleaned properly, and again the rope or the bundle of this mulberry branches together with larvae can be spread onto the floor bed and forming the new feed bed. So this method can be adopted in the floor shoot rearing as well as outdoor shoot rearing also. So to change the bed, ropes parallel to each other are stretched on the old bed and new branches are placed on these ropes. When all the larvae have climbed up on the branches, the ropes are rolled into a loose bundles. The old bed or litter then cleaned or removed from the bed, and the ropes and branches spread again, and the ropes and branches which are in the form of a loose bundle on one end of the floor bed, that will be spread again onto the floor bed, and thus making new bed, and it is suitable for 4th and 5th inch star larvae. So this is usually practiced in case of floor bed or the shoot rearing method. Floor rearing method, shoot rearing method, where we can use this method of bed changing and cleaning by using the ropes, where the silicon larvae are fed directly onto the branches or the shoot harvested that are simply kept transversely onto the ropes, and larvae will feed upon directly onto the branches harvested. So it is suitable for 4th and 5th instar stages, because in a 4th and 5th instar stage, the requirement of the feed is more, and that's why the silicon larvae are fed directly onto the branches of the mulberry, or entire branch, complete branches which has harvested from the field, that are brought into the rearing house, and mulberry branches are fed to the silkworm larvae. So this is about the three methods of rearing silkworms in the rearing house, that is self rearing method, floor rearing method, and shoot rearing method, or outdoor shoot rearing method of the silkworm rearing. And this is the way of the management of the feeding of silkworm larvae by using different types of mulberry leaves, either chopped mulberry leaves, either unchopped mulberry leaves, or the larvae directly feeding onto the branches. And for this purpose, these three methods of the silkworm rearing are adopted in a different regions or different parts of the country, so as to practice the mulberry sericulture. So this is a empty plural rearing stand. So this is prepared from the wooden rods together with bamboo strips, so as to prepare the floor or benches or the seat for the silkworm rearing. So this is the rearing stand or rearing stand, but showing floor bed or the benches of the seats. So there are four number of floor beds prepared on a single stand in the large sized rearing house. So this is the rearing stand used for the floor rearing. Then this is another photograph where we can see the column of the rearing house on the right side, and in the left there is a rearing stand having much longer length, and the rearing stand has been prepared to prepare the floor beds or the seats, and these are five in number. We can see, or we can count them. There are five number of floor beds prepared on one side of the rearing house lengthwise. So whatever the length of the rearing house, that can be acquired or where the entire length of the rearing house, throughout the length of the rearing house, the floor bed is prepared on one side with a width of 1 meter, and any length or whatever the length of rearing house, that much length of the floor bed or a floor bed or bench is prepared by using 1, 2, 3 or more number of tires. So you can see this is the floor rearing method where five number of floors or floor beds or the benches are prepared on which the newspapers are spread and the larvae are fed directly onto the branches. So transversely we can keep the harvested mulberry branches and larvae are fed directly onto the mulberry branches. So this will save the labor. This will also save the labor in spreading the mulberry leaves or providing the feed to the silkworm larvae. So these are the person who are involved in a practice of silkworm rearing, and they might be removing the diseased worms, or they might be looking towards the beds to see what kind of activities or how the health of the silkworms is present in the rearing or a bed. So this is the floor rearing method where five number of floor, or this is five tire, these are five tire of the floor beds prepared on one side of the rearing house, and in this method entire mulberry branches or the shoot are fed to the silkworm larvae. So this is about the various methods of the silkworm rearing. So today we'll stop here, and next time we'll explain the next point of the sericulture. So today we'll stop here. Thank you.